we overlap the isotopes with lasers.
Play me with some bass and drums, cause I'm about to go crazy dumb. Pay me some attention and I'll educate your cranium. Crystals, yeah, we're lasing them, sapphire and titanium. But wait, I'm out of order, so let's start it at the target. We irradiate uranium, then some decays to radium. Inject fluorine, we're making some radium monofluoride molecules. They're pretty hot and they gotta be cool. Prior to use, the spectroscopy tool. Apply a strong field and they follow the rule. Cause they're energized with the ionized fuel. Follow my drift if you had left school. If not, don't sweat it, don't matter, my dude. I can't break down kinematics for you. 40k beam in the cations move. Yeah, yeah, that's electrostatic extraction. Next we filter, then we trap a flap and quadrupole attraction. In all trap, we buffer gas them and that causes cool reactions. The ions are not static, scatter non-adiabatic. So the cooling's automatic, yeah, it's quite a useful tactic. Helium gas collisions induce a few transitions, reducing our partition function, thus upping precision. Next we're onto the charge exchange. Gotta change my flow, make the bars insane. So the beam pass through a sodium vapor, RAF, an electron taker. Neutral molecules exit the chamber, deflect the rest like see ya later. Now we're back to the PISAP laser, scanning wave number and logging the data. Heightened state of annihilator, level structure interrogator. Cause molecules are resonators, responding to strong oscillators. See figure one from our paper in Nature.
Nature.
Next we pulse with a 355 nanometer light, re-ionized only if we already excite. Ground state sigma to A2 pi, or a higher lying state if the scan laser resonates. Ions are detected once deflected to collection plate. Tweaking the frequency, seeking some evidence, seeing a peak when we see through a resonance. Technique is elegant, sleeking intelligence, speaking out beats, I'm a geek in my element.
We'll see a few examples in radioactive molecules having the ability to modify the neutrons and protons inside the molecules allow us to explore very different phenomena.
All right, we covered methods. Let's focus on results and goals. First of all, we had to probe positions of the manifolds for vibration normal modes, plus Frank Condon factors, so we know if we could trap and slow gamma damp molasses cold. I'm talking laser cooling, if that wasn't understandable. It's important for precision measurements on things like antipodes and other such moments that don't consider parity, plus deviation from king linearity, time reverse breaking, comparing polarities, find such a constant to track regularity, unstable isotopes reproduce scarcely, some of these signatures enhanced apparently from certain structural irregularities like deformations of large angularity. Got all that? Alright. Molecules, they magnify permanent dipole moments, plus they have more transitions to measure isotopes and isolate components that are higher than the lowest order terms of standard model effects. Count for them all, then what do you get? Well, if you are left with signal excess, it could be a sign of 17x or other dark bosonic coupling strength. Axion field, your shot, I will check. Shout out to Vuletich, with whom we're doing this tangle state measurement technique is ludicrous, though we are new to this method as used in quantum computing with trapped ion qubits.
We call this kind of flow a super flow.
Of all our science could have practical appliance like nuclear optical clocks to keep time with, and a smorgasbord of tactics yielding ultra narrow line widths. We keep climbing ever higher, standing on the backs of giants at CERN, effort been triumph. Looking for PT, we'll find it, then our paper we would write it, and then you should probably cite it. Oh my bad, I got excited. I'm just saying, future's bright and all the factors in alignment. That's a wrap, hope you liked it.